Hello musicians, this is Andrew Mercer, and in today's short tutorial I'm going to show you how to export a WAV and an MP3 in Audacity, so hold tight. In order to export a WAV or an MP3, we gotta have a recording, right? So, let's record Mason's Apron. Here we go. Alright, there you go. A little bit of silliness at the end. Okay, so now we have a recording. Let's listen to a little bit of it back. I would take it again. But anyway, that's not what we did this for today. We did this to show how to export a WAV or an MP3. Okay, so here's what you got to do. This is actually really simple. You just go to the file menu. Once you have a recording there, or maybe it's an existing project you already got saved. Now, if I wanted to save this as a project, I would save it. It would remember all of my settings, all of my slider settings, everything like that. But I wouldn't be able to listen to it on an MP3 player, or I wouldn't be able to email it to anybody. That's a project. You can't do that. What we'd need to do if we're going to put it on an iPod or we wanted to email it, we're going to have to go to export. Export's going to give us a WAV or an MP3 or various other types of file formats, but we're going to concentrate on WAV and MP3. You give it a name. Bucky Dirtle is my name, and Mason's Apron is the name of the song. So once you can put in all the other information if you want it, and you click OK. Now we're given some file choice types, file type choices. Let's just call this test. And you can see here under format, WAV is there, and we have a whole bunch of other ones, and we see MP3 is there. Now, let's talk a little bit about the difference between WAV and MP3. A WAV file is a lossless file. It's exactly as it was recorded. It means that there was not in the saving process or the encoding process, there was no data was lost. It was exactly as it was recorded. Okay, but it's also very, very big. It makes the files really big. Like the one I just did then might end up being, I don't know, 10, 15 megs. If you have an MP3, there's a lot of the data that's cut out. So it makes the files quite a bit smaller, but there's a very much a loss in quality of sound. So if you're looking for the best sound, if you're doing remixes or mashups or things like that, or you're bouncing tracks around between people, use WAV because you want to keep the best sound you can. If you just put it on a disc to listen to in the car, or you listen to it on your iPod, whatever, you know, MP3 will do you. Okay? So in order to do a WAV, you just select WAV and you click save. Easy as that. If you want to click an MP3, you just go to MP3 and you click save. And there you go. The Audacity will do the rest for you. Now, if you select MP3 and it asks for the lame encoder, there's another video I have here for you that you can check out that will show you how to install the lame encoder so that you can make MP3s. Now, once you install that lame encoder, you only have to install it once, and that's it for forever. So you might want to watch that video. If you're getting a request for the lame encoder, L-A-M-E encoder, then watch that other video. Okay, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. And if you got any comment or question, comment section below. And if you have a request for another video, another tutorial, hey, give it to me. And subscribe. Subscribe. Keep track of the new tutorials. Take it easy. See you next time.